Ma-huang from seed to speed. I've looked at the net. I've seen what's shown. I'm disappointed by the information that's there, and I'm going to try to give some really good info here that will help guide people to be able to grow this valuable herb from seed. So these are the Ma-huang seeds, and right here is a pot that has been filled with regular potting soil and sand mixed together, and it's down about an inch from the rim. And I'm going to plant my seeds right there on the surface. They don't have to be closely together like that. They should be separated a little bit. And then I'm going to use pure sand to top dress deeply. So those seeds are covered by nearly an inch of pure sand. The sand will hold them in place. It will water this and keep it warm, and then the seeds will germinate within a week or two. And the sand will help support the seedling, which has a tendency to keel over. So planting deeply in sand is the best trick I know to have good success with planting Ephedra sinica, the true Ma-huang. So then, as usual, we will give it a label and a date so that we can keep track of what we're doing. After some time, after the seed germinates, it's going to look like this. There's a young seedling in a pot. You can see these are the cotyledon leaves, these true leaves on the side, two cotyledons, and then a stem with rudimentary leaves. This is a plant that has a photosynthesizing stem, and the leaves are always very, very small and pretty much negligible, of low surface area so that the plant can conserve water. It's a xerophyte. It's dioecious. We have female plants. This is a four-year-old female plant, 4 to 5 year old female plant in fruit right now. And then there are male plants, and the male plants will make yellow flowers in the spring. At this time of year, they just look naked. Both the male and the female plants are used in traditional Chinese medicine. Ma-huang stems comprise one of the Chinese herbs that releases the exterior. They're used alone or in combination, often sweetened with honey for treating colds, cough, asthma, allergies, chills, fever. The plant is an adrenergic stimulant to the central nervous system, the CNS. It dilates the bronchi, induces sweating, promotes urination. It's never prescribed to patients who are suffering from high blood pressure. The negative press that the plant has gotten has been caused by people using very concentrated extracts of ephedrine from the plant and experiencing heart attacks and so forth. Using the whole herb in prescribed dosage will never cause these kinds of problems. The standard dosage is 3 grams daily. Overdosage can certainly be harmful. There will be a wakefulness involved in the stimulation, as well as a tendency to relieve the symptoms of asthma and the common cold. So it's an evergreen perennial, leafless sub-shrub, native to the arid windswept plains of Mongolia, Russia, and China, hardy to zones 3 to 9. The shrubs attain a height of 1 to 2 feet, and these examples that we're looking at here may be slightly taller because they're given plenty of water. I've noticed that during, especially during the fruiting phases, the plants do well with plenty of water. And sometimes on a good year, the fruit can be extensive. What we're looking at here are primarily male plants that have produced the upright stems. And these will be allowed to grow throughout the summer and then will be harvested in October simply by coming in like this and snipping, giving it a haircut with scissors. Then those stems will be dried. They become somewhat yellow when they're dried. And they can be chopped up and made into the tea. So Ma-huang really requires exceptional drainage, both in the planting situation and also in the growing situation. So you can see here we've got it up on a raised bed to increase drainage. These are very old plants that you're seeing here, whereas these are five-year-old plants. They've just come to their sexual maturity, and they're planted in a deep layer of volcanic pumice. That's very important to keep the crown dry. That's one of the problems you have with creating an unhealthy Ma-huang plant, is if the crown is not dry. It's not that they don't like water, it's that they don't like to sit in water. So planting your seedling out at about 2-foot spacing, you're going to find that they grow very slowly. Here's a 3-year-old plant here. This is a real beauty, actually. And it's really beginning to claim its own. But this should be snipped back in the fall. And then the following year, it'll be just a little bit bigger. And they grow on like that until they start to reach their mature phase. And then they are a bit rhizomatous. They'll send out underground runners, and those runners will come up as new plants. And so planted in this manner, eventually these plants are going to interlock and become a stand. But in the meantime, they need to grow on, and they require absolutely no fertilizer. Fertilizer is abhorred by the plant and should never be used. Instead, to maintain the plant, you simply go around, remove the weeds, and disturb the surface. This is one of the plants that really likes a disturbed surface. So then you just leave it for a while like that, water it again, remove any dead growth, very yellowed or woody portions. The plant contains ephedrine and pseudoephedrine and is very, very potent. This is an older plant in fruit. Ma-huang lives for a really long time, upwards of 100 years. That's one of the advantages of slow growing, is long lifespan. The fruits in June are half ripe, so they'll become extremely bright red, and each one of these fruits clasps 2 seeds. In order to harvest the fruits for the purpose of seed saving, you have to let them become completely mature before picking. They should be almost wrinkled and falling from the plant. And then the fruits are removed and the seeds are extracted individually by parting the fruity portion and squeezing out the seed. The fruits are edible and very sweet and delicious. Before I close, I wanted to show you one other species of Ephedra. This is the Chinese herb, Ephedra equisetina, which is known as green stem Ephedra. It makes a woodier base and has a taller growth habit. The medicinal uses are the same. Both plants, both species are rich in ephedra, alkaloids, ephedrine, and pseudoephedrine. And that is what I wanted to say about Ma-huang. Make it be of the medicine, make it be of the earth, make it be for the people, and make it be for the plants.